Should I go tell them to click on the link?
Just do a browser tab. Yeah. It doesn't work.
Well, like, I've tried it. Go tell them to click the links?
Yeah.
Wait, who did you whisper it to?
Muffs.
Muffs and Burning Ice.
I don't know who either of those people look like.
Is he here?
Okay. Okay.
Wait, Muffs. Mr. Muffin.
Yo, look at the, click the link.
Dan, are we still vetoing down to six or is it down to three?
What?
Is it, are we
six?
Can you tell their captain?
Oh, we're using the fortunes? Wait, where's the 365 day? What?
There are 356 days in a year. You veto like regular?
And you gotta try to live your dream every single one of those 356
go
days.
Go on BattleNet. Go on BattleNet.
Put down the wall.
Put down the wall.
Put down the
wall.
Just remember, there's always a way if you're committed.
We sent it again to Burning Ice. We sent it again to Burning Ice.
It happened during my game too. It happened once before the game.
What happened?
I lagged out.
Can you help him?
I don't know how to help him. It just happens.
Do something.
Please. What am I gonna do?
What am I gonna do?
I don't know.
Exactly.
So just tell him
play
it'll be okay.
Around
we
it.
Can always pause.
Can you, you're not gonna lag out of the game. You just check your Ethernet cord, I guess.
Yeah, I would probably do that.
I want a cat in the chat.
Bada bing, bada boom.
Wow. How does it feel?
It feels good, man.
We're the casters, yeah. So, dude. Alright.
It's for the UCGC.
Oh, is it actually for? Got the hammer.
Alright, are you ready, casters?
Yeah. Not really good.
You like it?
Hell yeah.
I take bad pictures, so anything.
Hell yeah.
Heck yeah. Frick yeah, dude. Can I get a frick yeah in chat?
Hey, a frick yeah in chat, please.
Good.
This thing is soft.
You're almost competent. Congratulations.
Is this how I stream?
Congratulations.
Hey, Muffs, can you click the link I sent you?
Yeah, he's on the track.
What? Hey, I sent you the GSLW one?
It doesn't matter either way. It doesn't matter either way, if you think about it. That's a swear. Heck yeah, dude.
I'm a caster.
This is a PG-13.
Call me Artosis.
Environment. Call me Tasteless.
We're starting. We're doing map draft.
We're trying.
Yo, Artosis and Tasteless are ours. Okay.
Huh?
What happened? I left for like half an hour.
I don't know.
Oh my god.
Is the map draft up?
Map draft is up.
Well, GSLW still hasn't clicked. Okay. Alright guys, we're gonna get into our map draft.
Oh, there we go. Let go of those guys. You can do map draft if you want.
Huh?
You want me to do map draft or you do it?
I can do map draft.
Alright, yeah, go.
Okay. Alright, Muffin Squad gonna ban first. They're gonna ban at Watchpoint Gibraltar, one of the many payload maps. Hanamura gonna get swiftly banned out. I like that. Nobody likes 2CP.
Hanamura?
Draw Namura, they call it. Muffin Squad with their second ban coming up. It's going to be Volskaya Industries taken out. Draw Skaya, they call it. And all the 2CP maps are gone, thank God. Nobody wants to watch that. You know, I'm hoping to see some Koth action. We haven't seen any Koth yet.
Absolutely. With these bans left, there's not going to be enough bans for Koth to be ruled out. So.
Yep. Eichenwald, another draw map taken out. A lot of broken maps in this game, I'd say.
Absolutely, and that's why we have this drafting system, is to make sure that we can get fair matches on the maps that these teams are comfortable playing on, so we can get the best matches possible.
But let's be real here. Who would pick 2CP?
Not many people would pick 2CP.
Actually, I think we were going to pick 2CP last semester.
Awful. And Ilios finally banned out. So
okay.
One King of the Hill map banned out.
Yep.
Ilios.
Could we see an Oasis game? Pog champ.
That's possible. Ilios, arguably the hardest King of the Hill map, I would say.
Yeah, I really don't like it.
A lot of weird chokes, a lot of weird small areas, very, very skirmishy.
Nobody likes Ilios.
Hollywood banned out now by Muffin Squad, so.
There's going to be one more ban left, I believe, and it's going to be Oasis taken out. So the six maps to choose from: Dorado, King's Row, Noombani, Nepal, Lijiang, and Route 66. We're likely going to see a Koth map here. So we're going to get that RNG going, see what map we get.
No, you're done. No, you're not banned. No. Yeah. So, wait, guys, come back. No, it's fine, you're good.
So,
bans are done. These are our maps. No, there's six left, you're good.
And then you guys are good. We're going to RNG one more. That's probably a good idea.
It's not holding, though.
It's hold.
Let me see.
Yeah, I tried that. It comes off.
You are correct.
Here, wait. Let me try and force him. Oh, there we go. Nope. It's almost there. I think we got it. Alright. Nope. Okay.
Rip.
Rip. I guess we're holding.
We're holding it, dude. And random.
It's gonna be one. So Dorado, gonna be the third time this is gonna be played. We're not doing Dorado. Two. King's Row.
Generate.
Three. Noombani.
Noombani's fine.
All right, we're doing Noombani, guys.
Sorry, I just didn't want it to be one or six.
Yeah. We're going to be playing Noombani, a hybrid game mode. This is going to be a really good map to test the teams and see which teams are truly better at the overall aspect of the game, both capture point and payload. We should see a good game here.
Yeah, a lot of people don't really like Noombani. Noombani can be super hard to push onto. That first point, definitely hard to capture, but
absolutely.
We're going to see how these two teams are able to tackle that. And I believe Muffin Squad is going to be on defense first. All right, guys, let's get hyped for this game. Muffin Squad versus GSLW.
So draft's coming out here, and it looks like we're going to be seeing a bit of a wonky comp coming out from GSLW. Playing the Samba, playing the Hanzo.
There is no way they're picking that.
Playing the Junkrat. Most likely going to be switching off of those, though.
Yeah, so Muffin Squad are going to be defending first, as I thought, and they are going to be running Pharah Soldier. What do you think about that Pharah with that a Pocket Mercy? Do you think that GSLW is going to be able to take care of that?
I think...
You want to pause it? Control. It's not on this.
It's on that.
It's on pause.
That.
Pause it.
Control shift plus. Control shift plus.
Wait, Mark. What else? Oh, you guys have to talk closer to this.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're going to go into a pause here, but I think that Pharah doesn't necessarily need that Pocket Mercy. I think Pharah is strong nonetheless. I think it's just going to be up to the hit scan on GSLW to take care of that Pharah. And it's really going to be up to the hit scan there. It's
going to
be a real test of mechanical skill if that hit scan can shut that Pharah down. Because if they can't...
These are wrong, by the way. Should be swapped. There we go.
So we have a DC, unfortunately, so a game that was about to start, not quite going to start yet, but we'll get into it as soon as possible. DC'd.
Yeah.
Difficulties.
Do you see a fail fish?
DC on land.
DC on land, lol.
DC on land. That's actually an interesting point to bring up. Blizzard, I'm pretty sure, has not implemented a true LAN client for this game. All tournaments, I believe, are played on Blizzard servers.
Yeah, that's something they really need to look into.
Absolutely. No dedicated LAN
with the Overwatch League coming soon, they really need to get that handled.
You can talk about that on stream.
Nah. It's fine. It's true. It's true enough.
It's true enough.
True enough.
You can say it if it's true.
Yeah.
You can say it if it's true.
I mean, Euro's a little bit scared of playing my team later, so.
Oof.
Who can blame him for throwing some shade my way?
But I do really, really like Muff Squad's comp. It's got a little bit of everything. You have the hit scan, you have the splash damage from the Pharah, you have the two best healers in the game, and you have a Roadhog right now, which is super meta after the ult charge nerf, because being able to hook people is really, really valuable. Getting those picks, really, really valuable, especially now that ult charge is slower. These fights aren't dependent on these massive ults all the time, and getting that one pick can really open a fight up, especially before ult charges are... have been charged. So say the Mercy doesn't have res yet because it takes longer to charge now. You find a hook on the Lucio, boom, Mercy's now soloing. Really, really hard to deal with that. So Roadhog, super meta right now, super strong pickup. And of course the Reinhardt, staple of the game. Need that shield to stand behind, all your team's just gonna get shredded.
Yeah, Roadhog absolutely gonna be a great pick against this Winston. If they do pick the Winston, Roadhog nearly one-shots him. You know, it's gonna be 400 at least damage coming through to that Winston if he hits the headshot. Not going to be looking good for Burning Ice. But we'll see if he chooses to go with that Winston. We haven't seen a lot of Ana coming out from GSLW. I don't know if they just don't want to pick it or if they don't feel comfortable with it, but they are not picking it up.
Yeah, especially in offense, being able to throw that nuke out, give people purple, make sure they can't heal. That's another really, really strong tool for finding picks. If you find a grenade on a Reinhardt, He can't be healed by Ozana, even if he gets grenaded by Ozana. So it's a really, really good way to find opening picks, find opening kills. Really, really strong offensive ability that I don't think is utilized often enough by lower tier players. They don't understand how strong making somebody purple really is in this game. It's a really, really strong thing.
Absolutely. And a nade, one of the strongest abilities in the game.
If not the strongest.
If not the strongest.
Not ultimate, at least.
Yep. Yeah, definitely the strongest form of soft CC being that purple. And it looks like we're getting underway here. The last player logging back in for GSLW. So we're gonna get underway. The final player gonna be playing on DanLee43's account, and he is going to be making a return appearance. So we're gonna unpause this game and get right into it here.
Control shift plus. Control shift minus.
Control shift plus. You can unpause it.
He's changing settings.
Oh, okay.
They just need to change settings. Oh, that's about how long.
Thinking emoji.
Thinking emoji.
All right, we're going to get underway here. We got a big crowd here. Let's get some hype for GSLW, please.
Gates opening in 10 seconds to see what picks are coming out for GSLW. They're going to be running the Widow and the Genji. Really, really awkward, but potentially powerful combination.
Well, let's get some hype for Muffin Squad, please. All right, so we're going to get underway here. Looks like they're going to go left. And an instant pick onto Baron.
On this is a really good opportunity to push.
They need to push this right now.
Now pushing in.
That soldier Vera pick is huge.
Finding a lot of damage onto Baron. Already on the point is GSLW. Are they going to be able to convert this? Baron in the air going to be needed to be taken care of. Roadhog now purple. Slash blue Roadhog going down.
Sarge going
Widow.
Down from burning ice.
Widow, one shot. Could be the end of the Pharah? Not able to find it.
Not able to find it. Let's see.
Still raining health.
They're still have a man advantage here. But it's slowly fading. It's going to look like it's going to be a hold, possibly, from Muffin Squad. Yep, that Eugene, he's going off right now. They got a res, though. Two-man res. That was a really fast Mercy ult. Two-man res coming out. DanLee43, going to pick up a couple. And attack fires are coming out from Varun. Going to clean that up.
And it looks like Muff Squad is going to be able to clean that fight up. Really, really fast res charge there. I didn't think the Mercy was going to be a good pick there.
First ult of the game, I believe.
Absolutely. That was the fastest ult charge I've seen in a long time on a Mercy, and that really cleaned the fight up. It was going a little sketchy. They're about to lose it. Good two-man res.
We're going to get another pause here. Just give us a moment. Having some technical difficulties once again. But Dave here to save the day.
Ice Alien though with that instant pick on the soldier. I think really
was Dan not here.
Oh boy.
So I'm saying if we can't.
Yeah, honestly. I mean if they play on the desktop it'll be fine. I thought it would be the thinking emoji.
Lots of thinking emojis.
No, give this to Nick. This is Nick's character.
That is Nick's character.
Nick got so tilted.
Did he?
Did you see him in our game? He got really tilted. When we lost the first push to Dorado, he got pretty tilted. I had to calm him down a little bit.
I'm looking back in.
So it looks like we're going to get him logging back in here. We're going to try and get this back.
Off.
Oh, okay. He's in. Alright, now you can unpause.
Alright, so we're going to get an unpause here. We're going to get back into the action here. 2 minutes and 35 seconds left for GSLW to push onto this point. They have a lot of ults coming up, though. They got that Widowmaker, Genji, and Reinhardt ult coming up. But other than that,
Ice Alien making a really, really strong impact early in that fight, getting that pick on the Soldier. Let's see if he's able to do it again. It looks like GSLW is going to be pushing
through the top, right? Yep, they're going to be top and through.
Genji finding good damage. Dashing through, is that purple?
He's super low, though.
Super low.
He's going to have to get out there.
Absolutely. Genji's still alive. Mercy going to heal him up now.
Sarge getting that pick onto the other Roadhog, though.
Opening the fight up. Ice Alien now going to have to take care of this Pharah.
Nobody taking care of Pharah.
Here comes the Lucio in response. Pharah is currently available. Paradox does fall. Sarge spawning, coming back.
Nobody even looking at this Pharah. She is just free casting. Going to punch that Anna right to death. Bye, Mom. And it's going to be another hold from Muff Squad.
Absolutely. This Pharah is raining hell from above. I think if GSLW wants to make this push happen, they have to switch off of the Widow, and they did, because the Widow, the entire point of running that hit stand is to take care of the Pharah.
Yeah, not happening.
Not sure if Pharah is the right choice here, because they do need that hit stand to take care of the enemy Pharah, but switching off the Widow that wasn't quite doing its
job. Are we not supposed to hear the captain? Or are you guys speaking very softly?
We're speaking into this.
Okay. I can hear you guys on the crowd.
Okay.
Another push from in that bottom. Rhino able to find the opening pick on a Paradox. But Eugene traded out. Eugene's fight so far. Two ults available for Muff Squad. Res available for GSLW. It's Pharah again created a lot of damage in these fights, finding a lot of damage. Baron finding a double kill. This is gonna be another Muff Squad. No, the res comes
huge
out.
Huge res coming out. But the hook gonna be good onto Varun. Varun has been carrying so far, so that pick is gonna be huge. See if GSLW is gonna be able to get onto that. That nano boosted Roadhog doing a lot of work here. Looks like it's just gonna be that Anna who's able to contest, but she's backing out, so not looking too good for Muffin Squad. I think they're gonna cap that point right here.
Absolutely. I think that was the change they needed. Swap out the Widow, swap onto a character that can just brawl on the point and take that wall and send it a fight. That really, really helps with the Mercy res as well. You get two drives on the Pharah, you can throw a flying around, take it down, the reser just comes back up, and just keeps raining those rockets down, and it's a lot of damage. So
yep, so Muff's gonna get a Fire Strike actually onto that Pharah. That's gonna be a nice kill. And they're gonna push this up. Monkey going in, Paradox gets slept, hooked, and he's gone.
Two down now for GSLW. This is a good chance for Muff Squad to actually push in and hold this corner, but it looks like they're going to be playing it back. Really good contested
grenade. Oh, here comes the ult. One, two, and he's down. He gets two off that, so that's a fair trade. Two for one. I do not think they're going to be able to keep aggressing out to this point, though. They're going to have to back up and reset. But it's okay because they have the spawns right there. So not going to be too bad for GSLW. They're going to get enough. Yep, they're going to be able to push this right here.
Two ults for each team, three now for GSLW available, but the charges are coming up.
Almost all of the ults on the side of Muffin Squad. Four to four.
Huge shatter
in the combo with the Pharah. Gonna pick up three, and GSLW looking really good to take this next point. Yep, chasing the Roadhog. He's gonna go down, I think. Oh, he got the hook, though. Could not deflect in time. Sarge, nice hook on there, but that's not going to be enough. They're going to be able to cap the point. Muffin Squad going to be put back farther on that defense. Nice pick onto the Roadhog. See if they can capitalize off that.
Absolutely, and they take that point quickly. That payload is barreling through the triple point.
Baron picking up two, though. That's going to be big. Baron is putting in... Oh, okay. Another pause.
This choke is going to be really important for GSLW to break, though. If they're able to break through this choke, that last stretch is a little bit easier to push, but breaking this choke can be really difficult because there's only two ways to come through. You come through the main entrance, that big arch, that your team really has to concentrate into and get mowed down with like a meat grinder, really tough. Or you can take the top flank, which is also pretty easy to cover because it's such a small window that you're able to shoot into. So
absolutely, but have we seen, we've seen Varen putting in lots of work, getting so many picks here on this soldier.
Absolutely, and every time I look, it seems like his ult is up. That means he's doing a lot of damage, putting out the numbers. You know,
absolutely, gonna get those four golds, lol.
And against an Ana Mercy, which has less healing throughput than an Ana Lucio comp, that extra damage, just putting those numbers down, putting those numbers down, putting the pressure on the supports to keep people alive is really important.
Absolutely. So we're going to try and get this technical difficulty sorted out again. We'll be back in a second.
just throw a soldier bot in there.
Just throw a soldier bot.
Just throw a Sarge.
Should we throw a medium bot at least? Or the easy?
The PM.
Hey, what's up?
You guys got it right. You guys
are
doing like a pass thing?
Yeah, we're casting the pause.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're casting the Overwatch pause league.
Overwatch pause league. I thought it was the Smite pause league.
Yeah. Not anymore.
Yeah, a lot of pause in Smite. Yeah, there is.
No, they're not.
Let's be real here. It's not called Smite pause league for nothing.
Not.
All right, so there's going to be a ruling from the administrator. No more pauses from GSLW, so if they DC, they're just going to have to go with it. Unfortunate, but we do not have all day here. You know, we got to get these games going. So as soon as they reconnect, we're going to get back into this. No pauses coming through, though. We're just going to keep this game going. Unfortunate, but it has to happen.
Unfortunate that GSLW is having these connection issues, because they're having good pushes.
Oh yeah, they're pushing really well, actually. Muffin Squad been put on the back foot quite a bit.
What do you think the problem is for Muff Squad?
I don't think they're regrouping well enough. They haven't had a whole lot of coordination. Coordination is a huge thing, probably the biggest thing in competitive Overwatch, and they just haven't looked coordinated. I mean, there's people running in by themselves, just getting picked. Burning Ice getting lots of hooks. And it looks like we might be good. Yep, GG Ice Allen coming back. We're going to unpause in a moment.
Game unpausing.
Yep.
Choke is going to be contended now. After able to push his choke, this could be a very fast game. Reinhardt going to get hooked, but Ana's even trying to healing it up.
And there's going to be another pick from Varen. This guy is on fire.
Where is he? He's in their pack line.
One, two, three. Can he get the fourth onto Genji? The Mercy res, though. He's going to attack Visor. Get that Mercy. He's going off right here. Down with the Pharah. He's going to get the Genji. He's going for the Roadhog. This guy is insane. Varen, insane on the soldier. He has just been carrying this team so far.
And really, really smart decision making there. During that tag visor, there was a Genji and a Pharah. The Genji deflected, and he instantly stopped shooting at the Genji, switched to the Pharah, waited for the Genji deflect to end, and then switched right back to the Genji, making as much use of that ult as possible. So
absolutely. Another pick coming through. This guy is just going off right now.
Helix rockets are absolutely nuts. Every time I look in the top right, the Helix rocket. But all advantage in favor of GSLW as well.
They're going to be able to push this, I think.
Ana's
down, though.
Varen
just not being contested. He finally goes down, but man, they have to contest this guy. He's just free casting all over them.
Already.
Yeah, he's nearly another attack visor, and he just used it that last fight.
This is a good opportunity for GSLW to push as Varen runs.
Nope. Danley 4-3 going
to
go down. And it looks like going to be another pushback. I don't think they're going to get any picks here. It's going to be GSLW put on the back foot once again. That ult coming through from Roadhog. Not going to pick anyone up, but a good zoning tool. Good zoning tool. A lot of people think... Oh, huge sword. Nope, not going
to
pick anyone up, though. Varen again. One, two. Can he find a third? And it looks like the res is coming through. Res coming through from GSLW, but
big shatter.
Huge shatter. One, two. Muff's gonna get two.
Good cleanup.
Yep, they are not. Oh, there's another. Three, can you get the fourth? He got the fourth. Quadra kill coming through from Mr. Muffs. Gonna clean that up.
A little extra damage. Clean that all-turn as fast as possible, but...
Absolutely.
Baron already at 60% all-turn. Can be comboed with Eugene's nano boost for a really, really powerful combo. But, I think...
Wait, can we just acknowledge Baron 70% ult again? This guy is insane right now.
Touch it. Oh, now in overtime, Baron gonna find Danny Fred.
Baron picking up one.
Gonna look for the Tracer. Gonna look for the Ana. Back on Tracer. Tracer's gonna fall. There's
Feral
a big Feral
coming down, but not
Baron's
gonna get anyone.
Gonna get picked out.
Baron's got ult again. He's gonna pop it. Go for that Mercy. The Mercy's down. There's no res coming through, and that's gonna be a hold from Muffin Squad.
Really, really strong hold from Muffin Squad there at the end. They had a little bit of trouble on the first point, and they fell apart on the second point. I think that's kind of where they had the problem, was they never regrouped properly. They never found a good choke to hold. They never found a good corner to hold, and they just let GSLW run through them until they finally regrouped at that last choke. I think that push could have been stopped a lot earlier if they found an earlier place to regroup or an earlier corner to take a fight on.
Yep, they were just getting super sloppy there, and Varen just not getting contested. This guy is just free casting. Insanity. He is getting so many picks, not getting hooked at all.
Yeah, the second Muff squad was able to regroup and fight as a team. They held that point beautifully. Not really anything that GSLW could do to push through there. So.
Yeah, GSLW not able to pick up their momentum again, and they're going to have to hold this point as long as possible. Looks like Muff Squad going to go with a Pharah Soldier comp. Pretty standard, except I would probably swap the Pharah for the Zarya, but...
Yeah. You have the Roadhog, so... Here comes out GSLW on defense. Let's take a look at their comp. They're running something a little interesting here. They're running double DPS, one being the Fair again, but the second being a Mei. We haven't seen too much Mei play, but Mei definitely a strong defensive character, so we're going to see how those walls work out.
Yeah, if they can pick up some good walls here, they're going to be able to stop this push clean. I really like the Pharah Mercy here from GSLW. They're going to be able to... If they're not contested, they can just carry this game. I mean, they need to get some good hit scan here. But Baron has been on fire lately.
Yeah,
let's
Baron
see if he can pick up these push.
Player, so if Baron is able to take care of these flying characters up in the air that could be a lot of trouble for most squads, then it should be a pretty, pretty easy push. But it's going to be all up to Baron here.
Yeah, another thing to know, absolutely nothing to counter this Rhino 48 on Pharah. They have nothing. Mei gets countered directly by Pharah, and unless they're getting direct rocket hits, you know, GG Ice is going to have to take out that Pharah. Ana can't be on the Pharah because she has to heal.
Muff Squad instantly pushing top left.
Yep.
Gonna look for an open and pick with Mei. You see Mei there, but a big
huge
from Sarge. And that opens the point up. The wall comes out. Reinhardt now is going to be walled off. Is Reinhardt going to fall? No, still alive. 40 health. 40 health is unable to survive. Finally falls. Baron gonna find the Draco onto the other Reinhardt though. Another wall comes out. Is there anybody trapped behind it? No. This is a good opportunity for Muff Squad to push through. As
yep.
they go through, looking for Mei now. Mei gonna be forced to ice block very soon.
Mei goes down and they're gonna be able to push this. They have a man advantage, but here comes a huge Feral picking up two. And let's see it. A nice hook from Burning Ice. Gonna pick up Baron. They're gonna stop that push clean.
And a fight that looked really good for Muff Squad really just turned bad quickly. I'm not exactly sure how that happened, because it looked so good for them for a second.
Well, it had to be the Feral. The Feral got two, and then they were just able to capitalize off that. Burning Ice with a nice hook. They're going to hold this high ground again. Ryan having his Earth Shatter. Let's see if they can use it to their advantage.
Muff Squad now deciding to push main Pharah in the air. Uncontested by this Mei. Walled off is Muff. Are they able to find the kill? No, a return card is going to find Big Shatter.
He's only going to get one with that Shatter, though. He got booped away. And the Nano Ryan going to come through. He's going to pick up one. But I don't... Oh, maybe two. Can he find a third? He uses the Shatter and he gets one.
Rez.
Two.
Rez comes through for GSLW and he should be able to hold with the Rez.
Yep, looks good. Oh, there's a pin onto Roadhog. He's gonna hook him though and get him back. Yeah, it's going to be a hold from GSLW, it looks like. There's two down from Muffin Squad, and nobody is getting kills here.
Yeah, that Mercy Res really, really coming in handy. A fight that was really, really close, boom, Mercy Res. Two more lives, two more men in that fight.
Yep, and Varen's going to have that TAC visor. I haven't seen him do too much this round, though. He's only gotten one or two picks. You know, they have to work around him because he is their carry factor right here. Do they have the nano boost? They do not, so they're not going to be able to do that nano visor.
May looking for another wall here.
Yep, if she can get huge wall, perfect combo. Perfect combo coming through from GG Ice Allen. Three man Pharah ult, they're going to stop that easily.
Really smart play letting three through before Maywalling. Normally you Maywall one person off, maybe two to get that pick. But they let three through because they had that Pharah ult ready to go and they knew they had the DPS to just take down all three members that passed through that wall right away.
Yeah, there's just not a lot of game sense here coming through from Muffin Squad. They're just getting killed by the same exact tricks.
Varen finding a pick, but it's going to be traded in response. Mayo is going to be coming out. And that Mayo looks like it's going to be enough to hold the point. Sarge low, burning nice purple.
Possibly. It's in favor of Muffin Squad right now. They're up 3-2. Can they push this? Sarge going to get the nano ult. He is looking for Danley 4-3.
Danley 4-3 going to be return ulted, but it's purple.
Huge charge coming through. Going to get the Anna. Anna is down. This is a scrappy fight. Let's see. Sarge gets another. They are up in a man advantage. They're going to be pushing this point. It's a 2v3 right now. He gets a charge onto the Roadhog. Sarge gets another, and Varen cleans that up. It looks like they're going to be able to cap that point, Kenny.
Absolutely. Sarge there going huge, getting multiple hooks that fight, and getting kills off of them. Really, really impressive job from Sarge. They're even talking about Varen this whole game, but that fight with Sarge, I saw hook after hook.
Absolutely. He was just hooking them off cooldown. And they're going to be able to push this point, see if they can get it farther than GSLW did.
2.5 minutes to make it to the first checkpoint. Are they able to do it? They're going to be able to.
They're going to play super defensively here.
Mercy slap.
And it looks like they're going to speed boost in. Look for that shatter. But Muffin's going to go down. Varen picking one up, but they have no front line right now.
Neither does the other team, though. Both Reinhardt's were traded out. Now it's just going to be a brawl.
Yep, Varen picking another one up, and they're going to be able to push this.
A lot of damage on that Pharah coming out from Varen, but not quite enough. The Mercy able to keep her alive.
He's actually going to go ahead and attack Visor.
Is he able to pick anything up here? No, he's not.
He's not going to be able to, but it's okay because that was a really good zoning tool. They all had to back up. I don't even know if they're going to be able to touch this point.
Absolutely an Ice Island.
And here comes Pharah. She's looking for that ult.
There it is. But the Reinhardt shield.
Yep, the Reinhardt shield ate all of it. Perfect execution from Muffin Squad. Reinhardt is asleep.
That's a Roadhog.
That's a Roadhog, though.
That's a Roadhog.
Whose man's is this?
Not Reinhardt.
Nope. So they're going to be pushing this. Nano onto who? I couldn't even
see. Huge shatter.
Huge shatter from Mr. Muffs. He's going to miss the charge, though. One, two. It's a 2v2.
Big res
from the red team. Are they going to hold this? 0.84 meters left. Huge shatter from Danley.
Swingy looking for the Pharah, not able to find it, but it doesn't even matter.
Sarge picking up another. One, two.
Rhino actually turning the fight. Varen as well.
Yep, another hook from Sarge, and that's going to be the cleanup. Muffin Squad going to take game one. They looked really good. They had 2.5 minutes left on that. They looked great. Sarge and Varen on those DPS characters just putting in work.
Absolutely, and really, really big.
You had to swap.
Muffin Squad on that one.
It's fine.
Varen definitely put in a lot of work. Rhino had some massive Pharah ults.
Oh yeah, Varen with that great play of the game. The Golden Gun, the Helix Rocket. Let's see this. Oh, this was what we were talking about before. Watch him swap targets here. So he sees the Genji deflect, he just swaps right over to that Pharah, and then he picks up the Genji. What do you know? This guy has been on fire this game. Let's see if he can keep it up. 77 kill participation. Insanity coming through from Muffin Squad. Let's see what GSLW picks for the next map. See if Varen can keep it up.
Yeah, this soldier is going to be a problem, and they're going to need to find an answer if they want to have a chance of contending, because 77% kill participation is just absolutely nuts. So they're going to pick a map, and I would try to pick a map here.
Teams.
I would, if I were GSLW here, I would look to pick a map with not much high ground. Soldier really thrives on that high ground advantage that Baron was able to find, especially on defense. We saw him play really, really well on defense. Not that he didn't play well on offense, but he went off on defense because on defense it's easy to take that high ground. I think if I was GSLW, I would be looking for a map here with not as much high ground so that Soldier can't abuse it, can't be almost untouchable the way that Soldier can be sometimes.
Yeah, I really don't know how that Soldier wasn't getting contested. I don't know if they just weren't looking at him or what, but he was just not contested whatsoever. GSLW gonna pick the next map though. And I believe the maps are what? Eichenwald, Kings Row, Dorado, Lijiang, Nepal, Route 66, so no Eichenwald.
Payload not working out that well here. I would pick the King of the Hill map.
You think they can outdo them mechanically? I don't.
I'm not sure because a lot of that was GSLW abusing high ground with the Pharah and the Soldier, and King of the Hill has a lot less high ground to abuse. It did look like they had the mechanically superior players just because their DPS were just fragging out no problem, but would they be able to do that on a King of the Hill map? I'm not sure, but...
I mean, King of the Hill, just complete mechanics, nothing more. There is little or no strategy. I think that if they do King of the Hill, but it's not going to be... If they were to do it, it would just go in Muffin Squad favor. Varen just free casting once again. But we're going to go to King's Row in Great Britain. And let's get hyped for game two. Could we give it up for GSLW, please?
Yeah!
All right. Little hype.
And a little bit of hype for Muffin Squad.
Yeah, let's get some hype for Muffin Squad, though. How about Varen? Varen going to be looking at McCree, possibly?
Perhaps. Definitely doing well on those hitscan characters. Maybe McCree he likes better on this map. Who knows? Definitely a strong character. Better than Soldier in close range because of that flashbang.
There's more utility from Soldier. I don't know. Personally, I would go with the Soldier. It's been what's working out. You know, you know what they say. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Absolutely. They are on offense, though, so they're not going to be able to find high ground as easily to abuse that Soldier, so maybe the Widow is...
Could we see the spicy Widow pick from Varen? I'm curious to see how well this guy can snipe. If he's doing well on the Soldier, it's possible that he could get some nice, clean headshots. But it looks like they're going to run the Symmetra from GSLW. They're going for this full-hold comp with the Mercy, Anna, Roadhog, Reinhardt, Symmetra, and Mei. I really like this comp coming through. There is going to be pretty much nothing to contest this Mei. The only hope they have to kill this Mei is the Roadhog hook. Possibly a Widow Snipe, but, you know.
The only contest they have for Reinhardt's Pharah, though, is Haya on that Ana.
Just re-log. Just log in.
Whose computer is that? Is that our computer?
Yeah, it's ours.
Why is this happening on our computer? This is the only one that happened.
It happened to me once, but that's it. I just re-logged in and it worked.
Okay, I got it by...
He's logging in again. Alright, he's back.
I don't know how fast it works.
Just invite him back to the game.
I'm sorry, we're
he's
like,
back.
We're like... I'm sorry. Good job, though. Good job.
So, quick pause coming out, but we're going to get right back into this.
Rhino 48, I'm actually looking to be of huge impact, because while this full hold comp can be really strong on these capture point defenses, there's nothing to contest the high ground, and we already see the Pharah in the air.
Yep, the Widow not going to get any picks, so they're just going to swap. Mr. Muffs with a huge pick right off the bat. Nice charge onto the Mei. That is a huge pick onto the Mei, but it's going to be quickly shut down by Burning Ice and King 23 WL.
Absolutely, and it looks like first push is not going to be successful from Muffin Squad, but that's fine because they have time. Our first push not going to be successful. Rhino on the Pharah, finding the high ground in a little bit of a cheeky spot, taking out those turrets. Really, really intelligent play. Those turrets really cause a lot of problems.
Nobody even looking at this Pharah. He is just free reigning up there. That Roadhog needs to go for that hook. That's their only hope of killing him. Unless this Mei has really good aim, she's not going to be able to pick those up. But an early teleporter coming down from GSLW, going to be put in that back room. and they're going to be pushing this point. Baron picking up that Anna. That's going to be a huge pick, but they do have a teleporter. Unless they take that out, they're just going to be right back into this fight
Mercy
in no time.
Mercy Res is going to be up very, very soon. That's what
and he takes down the teleporter instantly.
Mercy Res is available. Is it going to be used for a double reward? Oh, no. Mercy's going to die with Res here. That's a big deal.
Yep.
He'll come back with teleporter, but only...
Baron with the high noon in back. Baron looking for high noon, not going to get any. But it looks like Muffin Squad is going to be able to take this. They are in a huge man advantage right now. Only thing left, that Mei and the Anna. If they just fight on the point, they're going to have this. Oh, and they booped him off with the ice block, so not going to be able to stall. Ooh, the huge blizzard coming out. Can they get anything from it? They got one. Sarge is down. Can
Rhino's
they find anything else?
Rhino's ult is available. That Feral ult we've seen be very, very impactful. Is it going to be as impactful again as...
Oh, nice charge. Nice charge coming out from King 23, but they're going to sound barrier. It doesn't matter, though. They sound barriered it. No way, nobody's going to go down here. Muff's going to get another shatter from him. And it looks like it might be a hold.
Rhino in the back line looking for this Mercy. Mercy going to go down. Really, really good pick. Good time now for GSLW to push again. But not only two turrets down, but also the Mercy. Another teleporter, I think, available. Yep, teleporter is gonna go down. Rhino gonna be looking for that ult here. Teleporter is available for this hold, but I'm not sure if it's gonna be enough. Five people. Huge res coming out now for Monk Squad.
Alright, so we're gonna get some ults coming down here. King 23 gonna pick up the first of the fight. He's looking for that Reinhardt. Reinhardt is low. Can he go down? Baron swaps to the Winston. Nice shatter coming through. Gonna clean that up. It looks like it's gonna be another hold. There's three down. There's no way they can get this. There's no res coming through. And it's going to be a nice hold from GSLW. I am really surprised. I thought that that was going to go in favor of Muffet Squad for a long time.
If they're able to pick up this call on this Winston, which they just did with a clean ice well, that's a long stagger. They don't have that much time now. They got 1 minute left with a staggered Winston.
Yeah, only 1-2.
Maybe 2 pushes.
Yeah, one clean push coming through. But the Blizzard coming out from Mei. Going to pick up that Roadhog, I believe. That's going to further their push even more. So they're going to get, at max, one more push to try and get this point.
Absolutely. Rhino having a lot of difficulty getting damage past that Reinhardt shield.
He needs to just go on this flank route. I mean, he has just not been putting out enough damage. Muff's going to get a nice fire strike. Can they get this aggression going? Muff's nice shatter. And then Nano Monkey has to take out that teleporter quickly. The teleporter has to go down.
Red is available as well. Keep in mind.
They're not going to be able to get that teleporter down, and it's going to be a hold. 1, 2, 3, 4. They can res too. There's no way that they are going to cap this point. It looks like it's going to be a full hold from GSLW, looking much cleaner than last game.
Absolutely. Really, really clean game. Looking for the freeze on the Ana.
That freeze is going to be the nail in the coffin.
Here comes the last fight. Rhino looking for an ult. GSLW actually surging onto this point.
There's a slight possibility. Three down. Can they get it? Paradox. Oh, there's the res, though. But they do have a sound barrier in response.
They have to keep somebody on the point at all times. It's so close to being capped.
He is super low. Argon's gonna pick up 1, 2. Two down. Can they cap this point? They do. They cap it. Wow.
The cap from GSLW. Huge mail at the end there to pick up the end of that fight. Looking for a hook, not quite in range.
Huge cap coming through from Muffin Squad. They're gonna be able to push this up. And it looks like Varen gonna go on that offense with the Roadhog, look for a pick or two. This is really smart. I really like what they're doing here, creating a lot of space for their team to move up. A lot of teams, they think that, oh, we just have to play right on the cart, play defensively. But these guys are smart. They're going to push up, look for a pick or two, make this even more of a snowball.
Yeah, and a quick shout out to Pure for the 264 viewer hosts.
Hello? Thank you very much, Pure. So we're going to get about 300 people in here. Let's get some hype. Woo! We got about 300 people watching us right now, boys.
A lot more than I was expecting. Here comes the mail. I'm not sure if it's going to be horribly impactful. Soldier, Baron, looking to make an impact here. Doing damage. Going to get shattered. Going to get killed, but the Reinhardt is going to fall quickly in response.
Nice shatter coming through from Mr. Muffs.
Yeah.
He's going to get that pin onto Anna. That is a huge pick. Can they keep this going? Mercy, is she going to res? She has one. She's being greedy, though. There's two. She gets the res off. Very nice play.
Still alive. Ana doing a really good job of keeping this Mercy alive now. Blue holding this point a lot longer than I think initially expected.
The nanovisor. The nanovisor is going to pick up two. Those are two big picks, though. I don't know if they can push this any farther. It looks like GSLW is going to stabilize and hold this point. That is impressive. I thought they were going to give that up right there, but a nice res coming through from that Mercy. Captain Kior, nice job.
Paradox over the top there, over the top of the Renner shield with that nano visor. Picks up two on the jump. That's it.
Oh, they swapped to a Genji.
For this last push.
So that is an interesting swap.
Absolutely, they're actually gonna defense with that Genji. I'm not sure what they're gonna use that for. Stars gonna
I don't know how I feel about that.
Really cool pickup.
Nice.
It's gonna be a wasted.
Yeah, nothing with that Feral though.
Missed hook, huge on a grenade.
Huge anonade. And there comes that nano visor. Can he pick anyone up? Baron gonna get one. He gets two. There's gonna be four down from GSLW. Five down. They're gonna be able to cap that point. Not even triggering overtime, so they're not gonna get even slightly put behind here by that.
Maybe gonna trigger overtime. It's gonna get close.
And oh, it does actually trigger overtime, so that's not good. For anyone who doesn't know, the thing with overtime is if you trigger it, the next time it's triggered, it's super short. Like instantaneous, if you get off the cart, it's done. So they're gonna have to play on this point if it goes back to overtime.
In addition, I believe you get less time, am I incorrect?
You do get less time, so I believe
you, You do get less time for your next push as well, so overtime being triggered, they're not a good thing. Genji gonna dash in there. Let's see what Ice Allen is able to do on Genji. Not much, as he just gets swatted down like a flyby.
Yeah, I really don't like this Genji pick. This GG Ice, he should just swap back to what he was playing before.
Huge shatter.
Actually, only gonna get one, but it's important enough. You know, this is gonna keep the snowball going. Huge res though. One, two, three, gonna be res from the side of GSLW. Can they stabilize this? Here comes the sword. He's got one. He's got one. He's got. Nope, he's not gonna get two. Muffs putting in huge work. Muffs with a quadra kill. Can he pick this up? Can they res? No, they cannot. And it looks like they're gonna be able to push this in. Kill that Anna. Anna almost knocked off the point. And 4-3-2-1-0. That is going to be a cap coming through from Muffin Squad. Nice job. They still have 20 seconds left on the point, too.
Absolutely. And a game that looks like this is going to be full held, pushing to the very end.
That was really impressive turnaround from Muffin Squad.
They were finally able to take that point, the first point, and they had insane momentum off of the back of that. They just kept rolling and rolling and rolling and just didn't stop. They had a really hard time capturing the point, but it looks like their payload mechanics on point. I would just play payload at this point.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with Muffet Squad. And something to note, they have 20 seconds left on that clock, so they're going to get another push if it does go to that. If they are able to get those 3 points, then they're going to have another push coming through. It is way better than getting overtime, because if you get overtime, you don't get another push.
Absolutely. And that's 20 seconds, you can run a dive comp. You can get on point. You can.
Yeah, it actually goes up to a minute, though, at minimum. So we'll see what happens, though. GSLW going to be on the offense, it looks like. And they're going to go starting off with that Widow, I think.
Yeah, it looks like they are most likely going to open with the Widow. Very, very common on King's Row. The Widow is able to grapple up to where she was just up there. And there's another spot on the top of Speeder that she's able to hold as well. It's, yeah. It's really, really hard to shoot at her from, but she's able to shoot at you quite easily. So Widow is really common pickup here on this first point.
Yeah, I don't know how I feel about it, though, because it is very common, but it's also very predictable. Almost no one falls for it anymore. If you've played any comp game, you know. And it looks like he's going to swap to a Hanzo, possibly. Could we see some Hanzo action here?
I would be excited to see some Hanzo action here. I think Hanzo's underrated.
I don't like the Hanzo pick here. They do not have a Zarya to combo with it, so that ult is not going to be pretty much nothing more than a zoning tool.
Even though I think Hanzo's kit, both of his abilities are some of the strongest abilities in the game, let's be fair. Scatter arrow. How many times?
He does have Widowmaker ult with his shift. Let's be real here.
How many times have you been killed by that scatter arrow?
True. So we're going to get underway here. GSLW going to try and push on to that point.
And it is going to be a Hanzo. Now I'm going to switch off quickly.
Hanzo not going to get any picks here, so he's going to swap off. Going to Widowmaker, though. That is interesting. You would think that he would swap off to something different, but he's going to try and find some picks onto that Widowmaker.
I think he saw the Pharaoh and went Widow as a hard counter.
That's possible. Yeah. I don't know how I feel about it, though. They haven't been too good on that Widowmaker.
Big hook onto this Reinhardt, but Isana doing a really, really good job of keeping him alive, able to stay alive. Paradox in a little bit of trouble, but able to just jump out of there. Genji's mobility.
Oh, nice hook onto Captain Core. He's going to go down, so that's going to stall their push quite a bit. They're going to have to wait for that Mercy to come back.
Absolutely. Ice Allen needs to kill this Pharaoh or switch off with the Widow. It needs to happen. Pharaoh is causing a lot
of pin from Mr. Muffs onto King 23. That's going to stop their push even more. these guys just need to wait and group up at this point. They're getting hard staggered. If they keep getting picked, there's another one down. They have to wait. You know, they can't. They just need to go hide at this point. They're trying to just look for some poke. It's not working out. They're just going to keep getting poked out here.
I would go as far as to say I would just stand and spawn until the whole team's alive.
Absolutely. That is a strat that a lot of people have been
using. Huge hook onto the Ana.
He's not going to get it. He's going to get a return hook, though.
Ice with a counter hook.
But keep in mind, that Ana is down. That's going to be huge. Ana is arguably the most important member of that squad. They're not going to res him, so they're just going to have to go with it. And Muff's not going to hit that charge. And it looks like he might go down. His shield is super low.
Paradox is going to have...
Oh, huge shatter.
A big shatter.
And a... Oh, and the nice res, though. Feral coming through.
Feral
going to get shut down instantly with that hook. And it looks like the nanovisor coming out. Baron picking up two. Very nice.
Bernie Nice now getting mowed down. Just kidding. Going to get hooked. Going to get burned by this gun. Bernie Nice on that roadhog.
We're going to have to get another pause, looks like.
I don't know what to
tell
you.
Just log in again. Log in.
But I lost my alt. Where am I? Alt ready.
I don't know, dude.
Like, I wish I could tell you I could just give it back to you, but, like, I can't. Like that's our computer. Like, that's our fault. I'm sorry. But, like, it hasn't happened to anyone else. Like, there's no way we could have seen this coming.
So we're going to get back into this. He's gonna log back in. Everything's all right.
Like, if you want to swap like computers with another one of your teammates, if like you think that would be better, but like this hasn't happened to any of the players except for him once. Like, there's no way we could have saw this coming. I'm sorry.
They're gonna invite him back. We're gonna get back into this. Short delay, but we're gonna get back into the action. Yo, just invite him back. Euro in the chat, chant for a remake. I don't think it's gonna happen, though.
I don't think it's gonna happen. We don't have time.
Not only that, but, you know, this push has just been pretty much shut down. All right, so we're going to get back underway here. And we're going to see if GSLW can capture this point. They have been unsuccessful thus far, and they have less than 2 minutes remaining. Only probably three more pushes coming through.
Bernie Nice does have also a huge hook onto this Roadhog. Is he going
to
fall?
That is a nice pick. They need to push off that if they have any hopes of winning.
Absolutely. A hook on this Pharah could mean the end of the fight. Let's see if he's able to look for it. He's not even looking at the Pharah.
Burning Ice is alone on the right. He needs to back up.
Absolutely.
And GG Ice going to put on some pressure on that Pharah. Nearly has his ult. And that Reinhardt is out of position to the right. See if they can get a pick on him. But there's going to be a one-for-one trade. And it looks like Baron might be able to help him. Help his
Ice Allen with the air shot.
Air shot.
Into an ultimate. Huge plays from Ice Allen.
Ice Allen is going to help his team pick that up. I think they're going to capture the point,
Manny. That was Ice Allen.
That was all him. Him and Burning Ice on fire that fight.
That was insane. Two back-to-back air shots.
And the hooks were on fire.
Absolutely. Two back-to-back air shots, hooks, Pharah ults. That fight went really, really cleanly right there at the end. Some really big plays coming out from the individuals.
And there's only going to be two ults coming through from Muffin Squad. See if they can hold this. They got the Earth Shatter. And they're getting close to a lot of ults, though. On the other side, not too many. They only have two. And they do have that Mercy Res, though.
2.0
going to deny the pick.
So Baron going to get a pick onto that Pharah. That might halt their push, but it looks like they're not even going to contest. I don't like that. They need to get in there. They got a good pick. They should push that. Nice sleep onto the Roadhog, but... Oh, he's going to get hooked. He's going to get hooked. And the boop away charge. Not going to hit anyone. So Sarge picking up Burning Ice. GG Ice getting another one. Oh, he misses the shatter, though. Great block from Mr. Muffs. Mr. Muffs with a huge block. Baron going to pick one up. I think this push is going to get stopped right here.
Absolutely. Muffs outplaying the other Reinhardt.
Oh, yeah.
Perfectly.
Oh,
the res.
And King23WL going to get nano boosted. See if he can pick anyone up. He looks like he's gonna get one with the charge, but that's about it. Can Varen kill anyone? He's behind them. He might look to ult here. They have 5 ults on the side of Muffin Squad. They need to throw something out right now if they hope to hold this.
Absolutely. They have the nano boost. They have nano visor available. That's what they're looking for. They're waiting. You see Varen waiting in the back, not shooting, not enjoying his position. Hi-Hi-Hi with the nade, able to kill Sarge. I hear the nano.
Oh, here comes it. 1, 2. He's got 3. He gets hooked, but he's not going to go down here. They're just kind of ignoring him. Nice. That damage reduction going to keep him from dying. And Varen putting out a lot of work here.
Absolutely.
He's going to hold that.
Absolutely.
And the emote. The emote is hype. So that was a great hold from Varen, though. I mean,
yeah,
that combo was just perfect. And the damage reduction saved him from getting killed with that hook.
Absolutely. You saw him get hooked, and his health dropped to 60-ish. So it definitely would have killed him without the damage reduction.
I don't know how that Roadhog didn't kill him again. He just could have shot him, but, you know.
Oh, a huge hook from Sarge on a Paradox.
Yep, Paradox is going to go down.
Sarge,
so that's going to halt their push again.
Sarge looking really good on this Roadhog all day.
Oh, yeah. Sarge has been putting out work on that Roadhog. Him and Varen have been carrying this team on DPS, as well as Mr. Muff with those huge Reinhardt plays. So we're going to get that push coming through from GSLW, see if they can pick anyone up with this Poke War, but it doesn't look like. Can they hook that Varen? No, they cannot. So it's a one-for-one trade. Feral Ult goes down from GG Ice, and they're going to try and push this. Mr. Muff super low. He's going to go down to King 23. Nice hook, though, and he's going to get ulted. King 23 is going to go down. This is a very scrappy fight, going back and forth,
So low, but able to heal himself up.
Huge ult from Paradox, though. He's going to get 3 with that Dragon Blade. See if they can push that in. I think they're going to be able to. There's another pick onto the Pharah from Burning Ice, and they're going to be able to cap that point, I believe. They're giving it up, but
Paradox pushing in, looking to zone, looking to make some space, looking to create some pressure, and he's able to do that as the member of GSLW aren't able to make it back in time for the defense. And they are able to cap the point with 1:30 left on the clock. Are they going to be able to push it all the way in? We're going to find out real soon.
Yep, so this is going to be putting Muffin Squad on the back foot. Nice fire strike and a pick up the Genji, though, from Mr. Muffs. And GG Ice precasting up above. They're not even looking at him. The res comes through. I don't know how I feel about that. It was a tempo res, but I don't know. So it looks like Mr. Muff. Oh, not Mr. Muff. The other Reinhardt, King 23, gonna get nano boosted, but nothing.
Huge pin from Mr.
Nice pin from Mr. Muff. He did not block the shatter completely. He does get the return shatter, though. He has 3 health. He's gonna go down, it looks like. How is he not dead yet?
The support.
And 3 picks coming through from Muffin Squad. 4, 5. He gets 2 with 1 charge. We haven't seen that all day.
That's gonna be
a complete team kill. Team kill coming through from Muffin Squad.
With time for one.
Yeah, there is only time for one more push. And it's likely they're gonna trigger overtime. So a huge advantage coming through from Muffin Squad right now. We're gonna see the push coming through. See if they can get anyone with this poke war. But
Rhino in the
air. They need to go for that hook there. They're not.
Rhino getting low.
Oh, that's a nice pick onto GG Ice. That's gonna completely shut them down.
10 seconds to push with one man down. Are they going to be able to do it? It's going to be tough.
Nice shatter.
Earth shatter coming out from Mr. Muffs.
And there's 1, 2. Can he get 4? The res comes through, but I don't think it's going to mean anything.
Varen has pack visor available if he needs it.
They're just going to pop all their ults here. Burning Ice going to pick one up. He is super low. Going to go down. Attack visor coming through from Varen. 1. Oh, the return ult. I don't think they have it, though. There is only 1, 2 alive from the side of GSLW, and they're all low. I don't think they're going to be able to get this.
Nano is available. They can nano this Rhine.
Nano the Rhine, please. There we go. They're going to get that damage reduction.
There it is.
And they're going to be able to stay on the start, possibly.
Perhaps swinging away at the other Rhine.
Nice hook coming through. This overtime's only going faster.
Earth Shatter available super soon.
If they get off the point, they're instantly going to lose. But 3 picks coming through from GSLW. It's a 3-2 right now. 4 picks coming through. They cannot leave the cart. Do not leave the cart. Sarge going to get a nice pick with his ultimate.
Overtime is going to be triggered.
Varen picking another up. And that's it. Muffin Squad going to pick it up with the 2-0. Very clean.
Really, really clean game from both teams. Really good play from both teams.
Great play from both teams.
Couple times
Muffin Squad in the end. Gonna pick it up. Muffin Squad gonna 2-0 GSLW. No, GSLW did not win, in fact.
I'm so sorry.
Mr. Muff's looking great on that Reinhardt, though. Varen looking great on his Soldier and Sarge. So we're going to get that play of the game from Mr. Muff's on Reinhardt.
Not enough love for the supports. We saw that Reinhardt stay alive through
The Anna was doing phenomenal.
Oh,
Eugene getting lots of picks with his nade and just his weapon. I mean, he was looking great.
Absolutely. The supports did an insane job of keeping the tanks alive there. 38,000 damage blocked from the Ryan because he was able to play so far up with the help of those supports. Really, really great game.
All right, yeah, that was a really hype game. Wow.
I didn't know what was going on half the time. I'm not going to lie.
Well, it looks like that's it for this set. We're going to get on to the next set, which I believe Dave's team is going to be playing the number 7 seed. Eben's team?
I know, like, that sucks. I'm sorry.
I don't exactly know what the team names are, though.